In this video, I'm gonna show you how you can extract data from a given form field that was submitted and forward this on to your tracking tool, such as Google Analytics or the Facebook Pixel. All and more coming up. Hey there, and welcome back to another video of measureschool.com teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and today we want to talk about how we can extract data from a submitted form and forward this on to our tracking tools. Now, you're surely aware that there's great information available in a form that is filled out, like a contact us form. You could get data like how big is your company, what is your request all about, what are your preferences, what are you interested in? And that data normally goes into your CRM systems, so the request can be properly answered. Now, this is great data that I'd love to have available as well in my Google Analytics or my Facebook Pixel, so I can do segmentation, retargeting, analyzing of certain customer groups that have certain preferences, right? Well, today I'm gonna show you one technique to actually grab that data from a submitted form field and forward it on to your favorite tracking tools. In this video, we're gonna use some techniques in Google Tag Manager to actually dig deeper into a object that is inside of the data layer and pull out the right information from the submitted form field so we can use that in our tracking deployment. Now, we got lots to cover, so let's dive in. So here we are back in our demo shop, and in a previous video, we have already set up our form tracking. So if I fill out this form and send this off, we'll see that a Google Analytics event is fired that sends over an event for our contact us form submit. We can also see that in our analytics itself under the real-time reporting, see under events, a event was just recorded by Google Analytics. Now, you need to have that set up to continue. If you don't have that yet, then please go back to our video that I'm gonna have linked up down below as well. Now, what is new with this form is actually that we have a new form field here, the company size. And while we are not allowed to send any personal identifiable information like the name or the email address to Google Analytics, we can send information that we can pick up from this form onto the tool. Now, it would make less sense to send a message since that will be always different, but standardized data like this drop-down menu, the company size, would be really great data to be able to segment our users later in Google Analytics or build an audience of that we can retarget. So how can we send that data over and actually pick it up? Well, as you remember, if you have the form submit trigger installed, which we have in Google Tag Manager right here, here's our form contact us, and the event type form submission, the trigger will automatically detect when a form is submitted. And if checks our rules, or our trigger rules, filter rules that we have right here, then we fire our event to Google Analytics and data is recorded. Now, with that trigger, we actually have certain variables filled. So if you go over to the variable menu here, we see our form element, classes, ID, target, and so on have been filled. We actually use the form ID to fire our tag. So only if that condition is true, we fire our tag. Now, there's more information here. You can see the classes, you can see the form text, which doesn't really make too much sense. But there's also an interesting one, which is the form element. And here it says object HTML form element. Now, as you might know, this is all data that is currently in the data layer. So let's go over to this tab right here. And here we can find our form elements again. This is actually what's getting pushed to the data layer when we submit the form. So we have gtm.element classes, which is translated into this form classes variable. And we also have our gtm.element, which still doesn't give us more information here. So let's look into the data layer and the actual JavaScript object. For that, we need to open up our developer tools. Here under more tools, we have our developer tools. And here we can simply go to the console right here and type in the words data layer. Now, there needs to be a capital L. This is the convention how to write it. This is the variable. And when we click enter, we can actually see the data layer. It's a bit cryptic. We just need to press this triangle to open it up. So here we can see the actual events that happens or the page, the data layer pushes that happened. if you compare this to our event menu here, we see message, page view, DOM ready, and so on. We have 5 messages here, and in this case, we also have 5. The numbering is a bit different because arrays start with the index 0. Now we want to particularly look at this 5th one, so the last one, which is the number 4 right here. And this one has our GTM element in here and a little bit more information. So let's open that up. And we have some information here. This is really what we also saw in the data layer. Now let's go to this GTM element and actually open that up. And it gives us a host of information. What does that actually mean? Well, the data layer is actually filled with the event information of the form submit. So anything from classes or the parent elements, the method here of that data being transferred is also in this element. But the interesting part here is actually the input fields, because you may have noticed this already. If I go and hover over them, we have a few signs up here that this is actually activated. Now, I want to particularly look at the company size here. So I'm going to just scroll over and see right here. I can find that this element is probably our company size drop-down select field. So I want to take a look at this closer. So I'm just going to open this up again. And we have, again, more information here about this drop-down field. We have the options, all different information that could be interesting, like what the ID of this input field is, what the next sibling is, for example, and so on and so on. But if we look at this closely, and it's actually right at the bottom, we will find the actual value that this element holds when we clicked on the submit button. So in this case, it would be small business. So this is great because we can pull it out of this element and then transfer that into Google Analytics. How would we do that? Well, since this is in the data layer, we would need to use a data layer variable. So let's go over to Google Tag Manager, click on variables here. We are going to create a new user-defined variable. This will be a data layer variable for our business size. And as the configurations, we'll choose our data layer variable right here. Now, what do we put into the data layer variable name? Well, we're going to use the dot notation, and it's pretty straightforward if you know the rules. You just need to look for the right element. In this case, it would be 4. Ignore this element number 4, as we will check any data layer push if this is actually available. Where we want to start is to look at what is in front of the colon here, gtm.element. Then we go down, we see 14. And then we go down even further, which was value. Now, if I hover over this value, you already see 4 GTM element, 14 value. Again, ignore the 4. We'll just go with the GTM element at the beginning. Go over to Google Tag Manager, input GTM element. Then with the dot notation, we'll dig deeper into this object, which would be the number 14. And then we're going to get our value. Let's save this and simply try it out. Let's go back, reload here. I'm going to put in another test and send that off. Let's choose corporate and send this off. GTM form submit right here. And how did our data layer variable get filled with the actual value of the input field? Great. So now we can use that data layer variable to fill in our missing pieces in our Google Analytics event tag. Let's go over to Google Tag Manager, and in tags, we'll simply edit our tag here. We have a category action, and let's fill the label with our data layer variable business size. Again, this is just like a placeholder. It will be filled with whatever the user has chosen as his business size. We can leave all the other configurations untouched. If you want to configure this again, then check out the video. Let's save this, refresh, go back to our page. Let's do this again. Fill out the form and the message and choose a company size. Let's send this off. Let's go over to Google Analytics and see if we have a new form submit. Here we go. It just came in. And if we click here on the form category, we see that the contact us is now medium size business. So this was correctly transferred. Now, obviously, you can look at the data in a more comprehensive manner later on, once you have a bit more data in here, which is under the behavior reports. Under events, you will find your contact us form submits. Be aware that this takes a bit to gather the data and display in these more comprehensive reports. So there's no data in here right now. But this is really how you could send over data to Google Analytics. And if you choose to segment the data later, so only look at one or the other business size, you could always add a segment here and then build your own segment that looks at the events that only have the label small business size, for example. And Google Analytics would only show you those, which obviously doesn't quite work here in my demo just yet because we don't have data in here. But this is how you could then use that data to segment your users in Google Analytics. But obviously, since we have implemented this in Google Tag Manager, we are not restricted to Google Analytics. We could also send this over to Facebook. So if we had a Facebook event here, and I have prepared a Facebook event that fires on our page view and tracks the lead, we could add some extra data here by putting in a comma and a new object, and then expanding that to say we want to send over the attribute business size. And I'm going to send over whatever is filled in to our data layer variable. So in our case, I'm going to open this up with the two curly brackets and choose my data layer variable that I've just created right here. Then I attach my usual trigger and save this. Refresh. Let's try this out again. Well, let's go back first. Fill that out. And let's go with medium size. I'm going to send this off. Let's have a look at our Facebook pixel helper. We can see our lead was sent off with the custom parameters, business size, medium business size, and this should then be transferred to our Facebook pixel. We can have a look in the event debugging under the Facebook analytics section here. Here we go, event debugging. No, somehow it doesn't want to show me the data. I suspect that I haven't used this test account for a long time, so maybe it takes a while to populate this, but normally you should see that under your event debugging panel here, that there was a new event with that data sent over. So you can use that data as well as in the Facebook pixel. And obviously one other use case would be to use that variable in the trigger itself. So you could go into the trigger and say, I also want to have another condition in here where the business size needs to contain, it needs to be a small business, for example. In which case your tags only would fire if that is actually true. So really versatile once you know how to pull data out of your form field and then transfer that over to Google Tag Manager and use it in your tags and triggers. Don't forget, in the end, if you want to take this live, you need to submit this as a version. And once you press publish, this will publish your version to the website in Google Tag Manager, so your data will be tracked for all users. All right, so there you have it. This is how you can extract data from a form field and forward it on to Google Analytics or the Facebook Pixel or any other tracking tool, really. Now, I'd love to hear from you. How would you use that data later on for retargeting, for analysis, for different other things that I'm not aware of? That's why I want to hear from you in the comments
down below. And if you haven't yet, then consider subscribing right over there. Also click that bell notification icon so you'll get a notification once we bring out a new video, which happens really every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.